सुबह उदासीन आलुने मे मंगती से बड़वा सेलम बड़वा मत हरियट हदन बे भाई मल्लांगे इन विशेष आलू सचल सह निखिल एगोलोट मे सेलम बड़वा हरियट हदन पुलवा गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स सचल एंड निखिल वेलकम टू किड्स फर्स्ट वुड यू माइंड इंट्रोड्यूसिंग योरसेल्व्स टू आवर फ्रेंड्स
Hi, my name is Nikhil. I'm 12 years old and I have been using the Rubik's Cubes for 3 years.
Hi, I'm Sachel and I've been solving Rubik's Cubes for about 4 years.
Sachel, would you mind answering the first question? Can you tell us what a Rubik's Cube is?
A Rubik's Cube is a puzzle that was developed by Erno Rubik in the year 1974. He made it as an engineering project when he wanted to see if he could make a series of cubes turn together in one large cube without having it fall apart.
Nikhil, can you answer this? Can you show us a simple combination to solve a Rubik's Cube?
Yeah, sure.
Wow, that was quick. I even tried one of this and it was so difficult for me. Sachel, what made you interested in this brain-teasing toy?
So when I was about 11, I noticed that I had one in my house and I thought it would be cool to learn how to solve it because it seemed really interesting. So I picked it up and one day I just started researching how to do that.
Okay, Nikhil, what about you?
I also had one in my house and one of my friends came over. So he was looking around my room because he didn't have anything fun to use. Then he saw the Rubik's Cube and solved it in about 40 seconds. I got very interested by this and then I learned it.
As far as I know, the record for solving a Rubik's Cube is 3.47 seconds. How fast can you do it, Sachel?
Let me show you.
Okay, your time starts now.
Nineteen
point 3.68 seconds. Wow, that was fast. How about Nikhil? Your time starts now.
Of 24.292.
Wow, that was amazing. I've read that there are 40 quintillion combinations. Would you like to show some of them?
The thing is that you don't learn each combination. It's more of a step-by-step process. Do you want to see? Shall I show you?
Yes, please.
So what I do first is normally I make a cross. And this is the first step in doing it. So when you make your cross, you have to make sure these are matched up and these colors are matched up to make a cross.
Oh.
Then we do something that is called F2L, which is matching up pairs like this. Normally F2L takes the longest time and is the thing that people most improve on. Then we do OLL. Normally I do it's two steps. People can do it one step, but you have to learn a lot to do that. So first you need to get a yellow cross on the top. So then you do that, get a yellow cross. Now you have to get the full side. And last, PLL. This you match, take all these pieces and put them in the correct area. So. And you use that step to for every single combination.
Wow, that was amazing. I think we learned a lot about Rubik's Cubes today. Before we finish, would you like to share some other interesting facts about Rubik's Cubes?
Yeah, so one interesting fact about Rubik's Cubes is that only 5.8% of the world can actually completely solve one. And my personal favorite is that when Erno Rubik invented the Rubik's Cube, he didn't know how to solve it.
What? I want to add something in. The Rubik's Cube was originally called the Magic Cube when Erno Rubik invented it.
That's all the time we have today. Thank you, Sachin and Nikhil, for joining us today on Kids First. Goodbye!